In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Good morning, everybody. Great to see everybody. Isn't the weather exciting, actually? It's beautiful. It's sunny. It's going to be 80s. Come on. It's great. So if you haven't already, please open up your app so you can follow up so we can see, again, get our own personal message and apply our own personal meditations as well. There's some embarrassing moments in life. Maybe you caught somebody, yes, picking their nose. Very, very embarrassing. All of a sudden, somebody catches us and oops, you know, we're driving or we thought like nobody could see us or we caught somebody. Very, very embarrassing. Yes, we all have it. We all have those gases and sometimes they come out at the wrong moment, maybe in a job interview or something. And man, oh man, that's embarrassing. That's embarrassing. Tripping. Ever trip in a public domain? You know, like maybe they call you down and you're receiving something or you're giving a speech and whoops, and you just trip. Very, very embarrassing. But all those, maybe we all have to pull out our little like elementary pictures and we look at that and we are so embarrassed to show it to our parents. Like, what were our moms thinking? What were our moms thinking in those times, like dressing us on like, you know, on picture day for the way they did? Those are embarrassing, very embarrassing moments. And I had an embarrassing moment a while ago, maybe, I don't know, 15, 20 years ago. I don't know why, but Naveen was out of town. Maybe she was traveling for work or something. So of course I had the cooking duties and we're fasting. I don't know if it was a Wednesday or Friday fast or Lent fast, but definitely there was no fish. So I like ats. I like lentil soup. So I called Naveen's mother, who lives 5 minutes away, and said, how do you make it? And she gave me step-by-step directions and how to make it. And I fried those onions, and she gave me a secret ingredient of carrots, and it smelled like amazing. Everything smelled right. And then I'm at the last step where, you know, like lentils soak up the water. They soak up the water, so it's kind of thick. So you kind of like little hand blender, and you hand blend the whole thing, and you strain it. So she said, yeah, then you strain it, and then everything is done. I said, okay, I'm at the last step, and I'm straining. And I'm like, you know, Nick, Alex, it's dinner time. And then they see this. And I strained it, but I kept the wrong part of what you're supposed to strain. And I called her, and she could not stop laughing. For at least 50, I had to call her 3 times, and she could not stop laughing. And that was very embarrassing. Why are we talking about embarrassment today? Why are we talking about embarrassment? Because St. Augustine talked about embarrassment. And we want to take our meditation from St. Augustine today. So he said the following, say what you like, but for our part, let us climb the sycamore tree and see Jesus. The reason you cannot see Jesus is that you are ashamed to climb the sycamore tree. And we must not be ashamed of the cross of Christ, but we must fix it on our foreheads where the seat of shame is. So we won't focus on the second part about the church always relates this story, this tree, to the cross, which, by the way, so like on Palm Sunday, this will be the Matins gospel. So we always relate it to the suffering. And that's actually why we just celebrated the Feast of the Cross. So the first Sunday after the Feast of the Cross is Zacchaeus, because they always link the cross to Zacchaeus. So Zacchaeus, unable to see Jesus through the crowd, but he was unashamed to climb the tree of folly. As we said in the kids' sermon right now, it is not normal for a grown man to climb a tree. Like that was like, everybody was like, what is this guy doing? That was not a normal thing. That was not a distinguished gentleman thing to do. So he was embarrassed, or he embarrassed himself. He embarrassed himself so that he could see Jesus. And he wasn't the only one. In the Old Testament, there was a great story when the ark, for a period of time, was in the hands of the Philistines. But then a great, great day in Israel's history. The ark was finally captured, and then there was a procession into Jerusalem, and David was there, and he sees the ark, and what does he do? Dances. He dances like crazy. He dances like crazy to the point that his wife was embarrassed. She's like, I don't know this guy. I don't know what he's doing. I don't know what kind of dance this move. This guy does not have the moves. So his wife was so embarrassed. David didn't care. He was dancing. He's dancing his heart out. And he wasn't embarrassed to show his joy for Christ. Another man, one man climbed, which we talked about today with Zacchaeus, but another man was running. And that's the father of the prodigal son. Again, grown men don't climb. Grown men don't run. They don't run. So here's a guy, the story of the lost son, who basically spent all his dad's money, and he's coming back, and we see the love of the father, of course, but we see it in running. He wasn't embarrassed. Like, he could have just waited at his door, right? And again, grown men don't run. I know that's normal for us, and we all like running is a healthy thing, but they don't run. They don't run. And he wasn't embarrassed. He wasn't embarrassed to show his great love. Moses, in front of Pharaoh, all 10 times, he wasn't embarrassed. Even every time was a rejection. And he was embarrassed to ask more and more. And finally, our three youth and Daniel, who were not embarrassed. In the midst, like, they were chosen as the wise people. And they were basically with everybody else in a strange land. And they were asked to eat food that was maybe not literally kosher. And they said, no. No, we don't eat that stuff. We eat veggies. They weren't embarrassed. Why? Why do we get embarrassed? Why do we get embarrassed? We get embarrassed because of rejection. We feel like we're going to get rejected. Right? So we don't maybe do things that we typically would like to do. Our like true self would want to do something, but we get embarrassed. So I don't know if they're going to accept me. So maybe fear of rejection. Maybe I just want to be like everybody else. You know, I don't want to bring my full sandwich to church. I just want to like PB&J, man. I don't care if I hate it. I just want to be like everybody else. Just conform. Or maybe there's just pressure or just social anxiety that you have that embarrasses us. And again, certain situations. St. Paul said the following in 2 Timothy. He said, therefore, do not be ashamed of the testimony of our Lord. Do not be ashamed of the testimony of our Lord. Nor of me, his prisoner, but share with me in the sufferings of the gospel according to the power of God. For this reason I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed, and I'm persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. And again, so three different times in just a few verses, from 8, 12, and 16, he says, the Lord grant mercy to the household of Onesiphorus, for he often refreshed me and was not ashamed of my chain. He talked about shame. If we are not embarrassed, if we are not ashamed, remember, we're afraid of rejection. We're trying to conform. We're trying to do something that we're not. So in other words, when we don't do that, in other words, when we embarrass ourselves, when we show that we are not ashamed of who we are, we actually show that we're authentic. We show the true self. We show the true self of us. We also witness, and we become his disciple. And we'll show different ways why, how, when we embarrass ourselves. And sometimes you're saying, well, I don't embarrass. If you're not embarrassed, that's even great. But sometimes we have to put ourselves out there, like Zacchaeus, like David dancing, like the father running. We got to put ourselves out there, and all to just be who we are for the sake of seeing Christ. When we have this, we have a heavenly outlook. Like, we don't care. Right? We just can't help it, actually. We can't help express our joy. We can't help show our true self, our true Christian self, to the world. We can't help it. And as St. Paul said, actually, even if we have to, then we suffer. All right, maybe I put myself out there, and maybe somebody makes fun of me. Yeah, then we share in the sufferings of Christ. We share in the sufferings, as St. Paul just mentioned right there, with me, to share with me in the sufferings of the gospel. See St. Paul? He wasn't ashamed. He was never ashamed wherever he went. He said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to salvation for everyone who believes, for the Jews first and for the Greeks. I determined not to know anything except among you, except Jesus Christ and him crucified. He didn't care. He just couldn't help it. Like, he couldn't help wherever he went. This is who I am. This is what I'm preaching. Embarrassed. Doesn't, whatever it is. He did not care. He couldn't help it. He couldn't help it. So practically, and we'll end with this. Where can I do this? Where can I actually embarrass myself? Where can I actually put myself out there? Where can I be truly authentic, a witness, a disciple, to show, no matter what? Number one, just wear your cross. Just wearing our cross. Like, it's the most passive thing that we could ever think of. It's just there. We're wearing our cross, and it's a witness. It's who we are. And we're putting, remember, the tree is that cross. We're putting ourselves out. You know, maybe it's an icon in your office that you have, a cross in your car, in your mirror. Like, embarrass ourselves. Like, we hide it. Why are we hiding? Zacchaeus didn't hide. He was, everybody, the whole Jericho saw him. All of Jericho saw him on that sycamore tree. Secondly, pray before eating. Pray before eating. I mean, of course, by yourself. But maybe you're going out to lunch. It's normal. We all go out to lunch with our coworkers. Do we just take a moment and actually pray before eating? I'm not telling you to ask them to pray with you, but you pray. Or are we embarrassed? In a business meeting, business lunch, CEOs that you're with, are we embarrassed? Embarrass yourself for Christ. Embarrass yourself for Christ. Pray. Pray. Fasting. Don't just say you're vegan. You know, I know it's easy. I know, I got to give a 5-minute lecture on what fasting is, or I could just say one word, vegan. Oh, okay. No, do the 5-minute lecture. And I shouldn't say lecture. It's a 5-minute sharing. It's a 5-minute witness. Why? Why are you the only person in this place that is having a veggie burger? Why are you choosing beans over meat? I don't know anybody. Why would anybody do that? I'm sorry. Why? Tell them. Embarrass yourself. Embarrass yourself for Christ. Embarrass yourself for Christ. And give. Remember, we said, when I do this, I'm authentic. I'm a disciple, I follow, and I witness. And I can't help seek for an opportunity to embarrass myself so I can get my Christ into that realm that I'm in. Why do we just say we're busy on Sundays? Like, why can't we go golfing? Why can't we go and watch 20 hours of football and I can only do 12 hours of football? Why? Why those other 8 I can't do? Why? I'm busy. Ah, the wife, you know. That could be true, but the truth is you're at church. I go to church on Sundays. That's it. Let's see what happens after you say that. But that's all you have to do. Don't just put it out there. Don't hide. Let us be authentic. Let us be real. Let us be true Christians, disciples, witnessing when we do that. Going a little bit deeper, those are all relatively passive, right? Those are really, you know, you wear a cross, you pray before eating. If somebody asks you about why you're fasting, you can say, you know, you're not actively doing these things. Maybe this one, the fifth one, is active. Ask if maybe somebody is going through a hard time, losing hope, sick member of a family, whatever it is. In other words, prayers are needed. Do I offer? This is active. This is different. This isn't like, this is now really putting yourself out there. And it's not like, hey, it's not like you're going to, you know, like take a cross and go over their heads and, no. Just say, would you like me to pray for that situation? if you want to do it on the spot or not even on the spot, just offer. Would you like me to pray about that? Okay, that one's a little bit more. I don't know one person that ever said no. No, I don't want you to pray. I don't. I've never come across it ever in my life. Even what if they're atheists, they don't care. They have a sick person. They, you know, like, let's try anything at that point. I don't know if it's because they believe. It's like, but who would say no? So even when I say put yourself out there, it's almost putting ourselves out there with almost 100% guaranteed rate that they're going to come back and say yes. And don't be embarrassed to state our positions. And maybe, again, this is active, or a little bit passive as well, right? If somebody asks us, what do you think? I don't know. Should we, like, what do we think about all these different things, right? All the things we're talking about in Cornerstone and everything, right? The whole list, whether it's politics, religion, sexuality, many things. Don't be shy. Don't be embarrassed. Actually, opposite. We do everything in our lives to not be embarrassed. And I'm standing here today to tell you, be embarrassed. Embarrass yourself for Christ. Embarrass yourself for Christ. This guy did. He went up on a tree, and they're all looking. Look how they're looking at him. Who is this idiot? Who is this fool? You know what this fool got? He got to eat with Jesus. He invited Jesus' house. And today, salvation came to that house because he embarrassed himself. I invite you to come with me and embarrass yourself with Christ. And glory be to God forever. Amen.